Chapter 1. The Tao that can be told is not the eternal Tao. The name that can be named is not the eternal name. The nameless is the beginning of even an end. The named is the mother of the 10,000 things. Ever desireless, one can see the mystery. Ever desiring, one sees the manifestation. These two spring from the same source, but differ in name. This appears as darkness. Darkness within darkness, the gate to all mystery. Chapter 2. Under heaven, all can see beauty as beauty only because there is ugliness. All can know good as good only because there is evil. Therefore, having and not having arise together, difficult and easy complement each other, long and short contrast each other, high and low rest upon each other, voice and sound harmonize each other, front and back follow one another. Therefore, the sage goes about doing nothing, teaching no talking. The 10,000 things rise and fall without cease, creating and not possessing. Working and not taking credit. Work is done, then forgotten. Therefore, it lasts forever. Chapter 3. Not exalting the gifted prevents quarreling. Not collecting treasures prevents stealing. Not seeing desirable things prevents confusion of the heart. The wise, therefore, rule by emptying hearts and stuffing bellies, by weakening ambitions and strengthening bonds. If men lack knowledge and desire, then clever people will not try to interfere.
If nothing is done, then all will be well. Chapter 4. The dew is an empty vessel, it's used but never filled.
Unfathomable source of 10,000 things.
Belong to sharpness.
Entangle the knot.
Soaked in the glare. Merge with dust.
A hidden deep, whatever present.
I do not know from whence it comes. It is the forefather of the gods. Chapter 5. Heaven and the north are impartial. They see the 10,000 things as straw dogs. The wise are impartial. They see the people as straw dogs. The space between heaven and earth is like a bellows.
The shape changes, but not the form.
The more it moves, the more it yields.
More words count less. Hold fast to the center.
Chapter 6.
The Vali spirit never dies.
It's the woman, primal mother.
Her gateway is the root of heaven and earth.
It's like a veil barely seen.
Use it, it will never fail.
Chapter 7. Heaven and earth last forever. Why do heaven and earth last forever? They're unborn, so ever living. The sage stays behind as he is in.
He is detached, thus at one with all.
Through selfless action, he attains fulfillment. Chapter 8. The highest good is like water. Water gives life to the 10,000 things and does not strive. It flows in places men reject, and so is like the Tao.
In dwelling, be close to the land. In meditation, go deep in the heart.
Dealing with others, be gentle and kind. In speech, be true. In ruling, be just.
In daily life, be confident.
In action, be aware of the time and the season. No fight, no blame. Chapter 9.
Better to stop short than fill to the brim. Over sharpen the blade, and the edge will soon blunt.
Amass a store of gold and jade, and no one can predict it. Claim wealth and titles, and disaster will follow. Retire when the work is done. This is the way of heaven. Chapter 10.
Carrying body and soul and embracing the one.
Can you avoid separation? Attending fully and becoming simple. Can you be as a newborn babe? Washing and cleansing the primal vision.
Can you be without stain?
Living all men and ruling the country. Can you be without cleverness? Opening and closing the gates of heaven. Can you play the role of woman?
Understanding and being open to all things.
Are you able to do nothing? Giving birth and nourishing.
Bearing it not possessing. Working it not taking credit.
Leading it not dominating. This is the primal virtue.